my NPC is a little bit American because I've been living abroad for a long time. And actually, I'm living in the United States. And the Afro-Cuban All-Stars is a project that we created back in 1997. You know that world music is not commercial music. So when you record an album, you need to have a band in order to go to the streets, perform, and then sell the music. During the times when the music was sellable, of course. Right now, you can download whatever you want from YouTube or Google or whatever. But in that time, back in 1995, I was in London, and I was performing with a band, my previous band, my original band, called Sierra Maestra. Sierra Maestra is a French mountain that we have in the eastern part of our island. And then we were playing with Sierra Maestra, and then we came to an understanding with the first small label. I remember that the office of the label was about, I don't know, 25 square feet in London, Cleveland Street. And then we recorded an album called Dum Dum Banza, which was a tribute to one of the greatest Cuban composers and creators of the mid 20th century in our country. His name was Arsenio Rodriguez. We recorded that album and we sold about 150,000 copies, which is a huge number for world music. And then I came to an understanding with the owner of the company, this small label called World Circuit, to record two albums, initially one album, which should be a tribute to the golden period of the Cuban music, which is the 50s. You know, we are not Romania. We are a young country. We have only, I don't know, 500 years of history. And then, originally, the idea was to make a tribute to this music, to this period, using great musicians of the old times, still alive, and with the possibilities to go to a studio. And then we thought to make a second album. The second album should be not with the punchy sound of a big band, but with a more sophisticated and soft sound of the Eastern music of our country. So in 1996, we went to a studio and we recorded two albums. The first one with the punchy sound of the music of the 50s, and the second one with the music of the eastern side of the island. The first album was called A Toda Cuba Le Gusta by the Afro-Cuban Stars, and the second one was called later, the Buenavista Society. So in 1997, we have the two albums, plus a third one that we recorded for the piano player, our contractor, for the both recordings, Mr. Rubén González. So we had the music, we had to go to the streets because otherwise we were not able to sell anything. So we created a band called the Afro-Cuban All-Stars in order to present the music. At the beginning was everything cool, but in about 3 years, the project exploded and became a huge success.